Good morning. Is Babylon the last word? Our reading today is from Jeremiah chapter 50, verses 1 to 5. The word that the Lord spoke against Babylon and against the land of the Chaldeans by Jeremiah the prophet. Declare among the nations, proclaim and set up a standard. Proclaim, do not conceal it. Say, Babylon is taken. Bel is shamed. Merodach is broken in pieces. Her idols are humiliated. Her images are broken in pieces. For out of the north a nation comes up against her, which shall make her land desolate, and no one shall dwell therein. They shall move, they shall depart, both man and beast. In those days and in that time, says the Lord, the children of Israel shall come, they and the children of Judah together, with continual weeping they shall come, and seek the Lord their God. They shall ask the way to Zion with their faces toward it, saying, come, and let us join ourselves to the Lord in a perpetual covenant that will not be forgotten. So it doesn't sound like Babylon is the last word, does it? A day will come, the Lord shows his servant Jeremiah, when Babylon will be defeated by another power. Mighty Babylon, who took God's people into captivity, will hold them no longer. We had the northern 10 tribes, the kingdom of Israel, and the southern 2 tribes, the kingdom of Judah. They were taken into captivity and landed in Babylon. They will come back. They will be released. Verses 4 and 5 describe a repentant people. The divisions between the northern and southern kingdoms, those are all healed and gone away. Now the people come back together. They're reunited. They return with weeping and seeking the Lord their God. They want to enter into a perpetual covenant with him. So this is one of those big picture types of vision. God's people have been chastened, but now he restores them. And they manifest a changed attitude. This new generation that's coming up, they're seeking for him. They're looking. They need to know the way back. They ask the way back. They haven't been there before. It's a new generation, but they're returning to the Lord, just as the Lord promised. They're not seeking their interests as a divided people, like, you know, the interests of Israel and the interests of Judah. So there's this final resolution. This chastening is not forever. It kind of looks like that. It probably looks like that to them as they go into captivity. Egypt's been taken out. And here are they taking out. Who could stand against mighty Babylon? It's the giant superpower, so to speak, in their world. And it looks like it'll be that way forever, but not so. God will overcome Babylon in his time when the people are ready to return. A day is coming when those who are willing will return to God, and they will be his people. Let's pray. Dear Father in heaven, there is an end. There's a time when the captivity ceases. Oh Lord, it's good for God's people to remember that whenever they're in a situation of captivity. There's a resolution. There's an end of this captivity depression. There's a time of rejoicing. Lord, it's coming. We thank you that you're going to bring that time for your people. Bless us, help us, Lord, to return out of any captivity that we are in, and certainly not to go deeper into it if we're in it in some respect. Help us, Lord, to be people of freedom, people of liberty, people who follow your word. We just pray for your guidance now, that will be a generation you can use. We ask for that in Jesus' name. Amen. So, Babylon will not have the last word. God will. Have a wonderful day serving the Lord Jesus Christ.